Welcome back to NTV at One. Now, the Ministry of Public Service has reviewed some of the standing orders from 2010 to govern public service. And joining me to have a conversation about that is the Minister for Public Service, Wilson Muruuli Mukasa. I need to say that very carefully. Yes. Good afternoon and welcome to NTV at One.
Good afternoon.
Well, let's talk about these standing orders and the reviews that are going on there.
Yeah.
Why now?
Why now? Because the standing orders we have currently were last reviewed in 2010. And since then, a lot of water has passed under the bridge. There's been new legislation. There have been new approaches, new policies to govern the public service. And therefore, there's need, therefore, to make sure that the new policies and new legislation are accommodated in the standing orders. And those areas which are now outdated are really removed, and we have a fresh set of standing orders.
What do we think that when we look at and hear the outdated bit of things, what could be moving out of this? Are there any particular areas you're looking at?
Well, for instance, in recruitment, for instance, with the public service. You know, in the past it's been that people make applications and what have you through really handwritten applications. It's no longer necessary now because most of the applications are now online. It is no longer a requirement really to put in written applications. So some of those things will have to be eliminated because they are a bit outdated. Yeah. And then various positions, for instance, there are some positions which are no longer necessary in the public service. Those have to get out, and then probably new positions have to come in as well. So the outdated aspects of the standing orders are being eliminated. Where there is duplication, that one is also being eliminated. Where there is lack of clarity, ambiguity, so we say, okay, why should the standing orders be ambiguous? Because if they are, then they are likely to evoke different reactions given different managers.
Yes.
And also, and that will cause confusion.
Definitely. Now, we speak of confusion, but also within the public service, the e-government, the entrance of the e-government, when it comes to particular announcements being on social media, online platforms, which places should we be starting to look at and saying, if this comes from maybe an email or particularly from a particular account on Twitter, we can say this is authentic?
Well, every agency, every ministry has a website. If it definitely comes, it's seen on the website of the ministry or the agency or the local government, then you know that one is genuine. Then the leaders of those agencies have Twitter accounts. And if it's a Twitter account which is genuine from that leader or from somebody, the worker in that particular organization, then that could be genuine. But these others, either the groups or, you know, use pseudonyms and the like, those might not be so genuine, and we might have to ask ourselves before we believe. We ask ourselves first, we ask even from the ministry, we even consult the more known and genuine platforms for confirmation or proof before we actually go ahead with what they're saying.
Yes, so we have to look at the websites. Should we also be taking a look at perhaps who has signed a particular document?
Oh, yes. The signature, sir. Is it the PS? Is it the PRO? Or is it the head of department? In the past, it was, I think, either permanent secretaries or political leaders who would sign for a particular ministry or particular department. But these days there's been relaxation. And the leaders, there's a commissioner or a director can actually sign. But that director signs with express permission from the permanent secretary or the political leader of the organization.
Okay, well, it seems that the Ministry of Public Service is definitely taking a step into the digital era.
Oh, yes,
and
sir.
I believe that everyone who is watching NTV at One today is embracing it together with you.
Yeah, I hope so. I hope so.
Okay.
And in fact, that's what it should be. I think since the world is moving that way, we can't be seen to be left behind.
Yes. Well, I have been joined by the Minister for Public Service, Mr. Honorable Wilson Muruuli Mukasa. Thank you so much for joining us on NTV.